Welcome children, understanding elementary shape. In this video we are going to talk about acute angle, obtuse angle and reflex angle. Quickly let me see what is the meaning of acute, obtuse or reflex angle. An acute angle is known as if its measure is smaller than that of a right angle. Now we know that a right angle is of 90 degree. So if we have any angle less than 90 degree, then it is known as acute angle. And is obtuse if its measure is greater than that of a right angle and less than straight angle. Now straight angle is of 180 degree, so obtuse angle is that which is greater than 90 but less than 180. A reflex angle is larger than a straight angle. Now reflex angle is larger than straight angle means straight angle is 180 degree, so more than of 180 degree but less than of a complete angle. Complete angle means 360 degree. So that will be reflex. So if you want to see, like we know that a complete rotation around a point gives us 360 degree. This is 90, this is 90, this is 90 and this is 90. Suppose we are taking this. If any angle is between this 0 and 90 degree, 0 and 90 degree, then it is acute. Then 90 degree we know right angle. Then if any angle is from greater than 90 degree but less than 180 degree, it is obtuse. Then any angle greater than 180 but less than 360, that is your reflex angle. So this way we can classify our angles based on their degree measurement. Now acute angle. So as we see, greater than 0 degree but less than 90 degree. We can see like an angle of 60 degree is acute, an angle of 50 degree acute, an angle of suppose 5 degree acute, an angle of 89 degree acute, because all these angles are greater than 0 but less than 180. In our daily life we can see the formation of acute angles, like you can see the roof top. So this angle which is shown by the blue color is less than 90, it is acute angle. We can see the angle made by this seesaw. If we make line like this and with the ground, this angle is less than 90, so this is acute angle. When we open our book like this, so this angle which is made between the two pages of the book is known as acute angle, as less than 90 degree. Next is obtuse angle. It is greater than 90 degree but less than 180 degree, like this. An angle of 110 degree, an angle of 160 degree. All these angles are obtuse angle. We can see like, if we see the rooftop of the house, then this angle, it is greater than 90 degree but less than straight angle, so it is known as obtuse angle. In this book reading desk, if we measure this angle, then this seems to be greater than 90 degree but less than 180, it's an obtuse angle. Reflex angle, as we know, greater than 180 but less than 360. Suppose we have made an angle like this. This side we have acute angle, but if we will take this side, this angle starting from this and going up to this arrow, this is our reflex angle. This is our reflex angle. We can see the beautiful example of the watch. Now this angle which is marked here, it is greater than 180 but less than 360, so this is our reflex angle. So any angle like 270 degree, 300 degree, 190 degree, all are reflex angles. Now children, let me discuss some questions from the exercise based on this concept. Before starting this, let me quickly recall our revolution concept which we have learnt in the previous video. If we take a complete rotation around this point and reach back to the point, we know this is a one complete revolution, and in one revolution we cover an angle of 360 degree, that is complete angle, which can be divided into four equal parts. each of 90 degree. So this is first 90 degree, then 90 degree, then 90 degree, and then 90 degree. And we have discussed that if we are moving from this to this, means 0 to 90, so this is 1/4 of the revolution. If we are going from this to this till 180, so this is half revolution. If we are coming up to 270, this is 3/4 of the revolution. And then if we cover 4, that is complete revolution denoted by 1, starting from a point and reaching back to the same point. Because we are dividing our rotation revolution in 4 equal parts. Out of 4 right angle, when we cover 1/4 of the revolution, when we cover 2 right angle, half of the revolution, when we cover 3 right angle, 3/4 of the revolution, when we cover 4 right angles all, so we did the 1 complete revolution. So now based on this, straight angle is of 180 degree, it means we have taken a complete half of a revolution. So best match is this. See, right angle, as we have seen, 1/4 of the revolution. So here we can match this way, 1/4 of a revolution. Acute angle. Now acute angle is greater than 0 but less than 90 degree, less than 90 degree, and when we reach 90 we complete 1/4 of the revolution. But in acute angle we are shorter of 90 degree, it means we are shorter of 1/4 of revolution, means usse hamari revolution kam hai. So when we match acute angle, so it will be less than 1/4 of a revolution. Then obtuse angle. Now obtuse angle is greater than 90 but less than 180 degree. Up to 90, 1/4 revolution. At 180 we have half revolution. So we are revolving between 1/4 to 1/2 during the obtuse angle movement. So here if we match obtuse angle, so it is between 1/4 to 1/2 of a revolution. Reflex angle. Reflex angle is greater than 180 but less than 360. So it means we can say we have more than 1/2 of the revolution. Okay, so it is more than 1/2 of a revolution, so we can match it here. So these are the correct options. One complete revolution, if it is, means complete angle, which is not given here, so it will be left. Then next, classify each of the angle as right, straight, acute and obtuse. So first one is less than 90, so this is acute. It is more than 90, obtuse. It is of 90 degree here, so right angle. This angle is more than 180, so reflex. This is a straight angle made, so we will write straight angle. And these two angles are acute angle. So this way we can classify angles based on their degree measurement. Thank you.